that, let's go ahead and bow in. Welcome, everybody. Also, in the coming days, look for some email. We are starting to wrap our heads around what it will look like in terms of social distancing, what will be allowed, when and if it will be allowed. I mean, we're not trigger happy on this, but we are starting to put our heads together as to what does that look like when we're able to open, at least in some capacity. So we as the staff team here are working on kind of trying to figure out what that looks like. And when we have that, we'll kind of send out a notification so you guys can start to be prepared as well for what the requirements will be to attend in person, when and if and only if that is safe to do. Okay, with that, let's begin. Some relaxed breathing. Place your feet comfortable distance apart, hands on your lower abdomen, and with your lips lightly sealed and teeth gently meshed together, allow your eyes to close and begin focusing on deep, relaxed breathing. As you breathe in, feel the abdomen go out. As you breathe out, feel it come back in. Breathe in deeply. Breathe out slowly. Be relaxed. With each breath, begin to imagine a cascade of relaxation flowing down the body from the top of your head all the way down to the bottoms of your feet. Feel your face and jaw relax. Your neck and shoulders relax. Chest and upper back relax. Let your arms feel heavy. Stomach and lower back relax. Feel that flow of relaxation through your waist, into your hips, through the thighs and backs of your legs. Allow your knees to soften. Feel your calf muscles relax. Your ankles relax. And the bottoms of your feet relax. Breathe in deeply, breathe out slowly, be relaxed. The next time that you breathe out, go ahead and open your eyes. And remember, the reason why I use the same wording through that meditation is to create an implant so that you guys, an imprint rather, so that you guys can have that whenever you need to take a couple of minutes to breathe. Hopefully some of that will start to kind of lock in and you can work through that cascade of relaxation for yourself. Okay, posture number one, embracing horse. Separate the feet shoulder width apart. Turn those toes in slightly. Get your tuck. Circle the arms back and around. And settle. Thank you. Inhale, slower the hands. Circle the arms up. Inhale. And press the palms down. Exhale. Second posture, ride the wild horse. We start in the middle stance. And remember, if you need to take more breaths than what I'm calling out, that's completely fine. Breathing is super important, so don't run out of air. Breathe as needed, and then as you get more accomplished with this, you'll probably be able to sync up with the breathing rhythm. Okay, inhale. Exhale. Slowly. Inhale. Small stance. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Inhale. Exhale. Large stance, back to shoulder width. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Okay, posture number three, playing guitar. As always, start with those feet shoulder width apart. Turn the left toes out at a wide angle, about 60 degrees. Shift the weight, keeping that knee over the toe. Don't let it collapse in. Then as you shift the weight to the left, circle the arms back and around, set the right heel forward. There it is. other side. Turn those toes out, shift, and step. And release. Shake it out. Posture number four. Any guesses? It's on me, right? Compass. So, shoulder width apart. Keep that tuck throughout. It's very easy to lose your tuck on lots of these postures, but also, particularly on this one, as we roll down over the feet, it's very easy to lose that tuck. And if you lose the tuck, then you lose the connectedness that we're trying to cultivate with these postures. All right, so again, lift up. But keep your shoulders down, don't shrug. So still shoulders and elbows down, even though my arms are over my head. And one to the left. Two, down over the left leg. Three, reach out. Down over the right leg. Roll up and back. And roll out. And up. Other side. And down. Thank you. Okay, posture number 5, double dragon's leap from C. What position are the feet? Shoulder width. 45 degree angle, step forward into a walking lunge, like you're about to push a bookcase or a car. My cat's hair has just floated off of me and is going up in space. That was interesting. And down for that stretch. Can't shake the fact that my cat's hair just floated off of me. This uniform stays here, so that means I wore that in, and somehow it got airborne. Pets. All right. Shoulder width apart, to the right. Step forward, push. And down for that stretch. Circle with the hands and inhale up, exhale down, inhale, exhale. And release. Number 6, rhinoceros gazes at the moon. We'll go to the left first. Begin. Do a knee and hip check. Make sure you haven't swiveled. Lower body still. Back to center. Other side. Center. Other side. Center. And release. hopefully you still felt your legs, even though you were doing, mostly thinking about your upper body. Throughout all of these postures, you'll hear me say, and Senior Head Instructor Fig say, that your legs should be doing, doing the rooting and the working through all of these. So there's really no pass on any of them where your thighs don't feel like they're working pretty hard. Again, any knee or joint pain, that's not okay. And that's not what we're going for. So if any of that happens, back out of that posture a little bit, send us a note, get in touch with us so that we can hopefully help you triage, the alignment issue that's probably going on causing the joint pain. But thigh pain, you're on the right track. Okay, posture number 7, ride the tiger. Feet together at a 45 degree angle, crouch down, get that tuck, legs, and step out. Push off. Other side. Push off. Switch. Floor feels extra sticky today. Push off. Other side. Push off. And shake it out. Phoenix spreads wings, number 8. Bring those feet in a little bit closer together, but still, I'm not standing tall. I've still got that crouched down, springy ninja kind of feel. All right, begin. Rock with that body so the arms come up and down. We've been doing these a few weeks. If you feel like quickening the pace a little bit, you can. If you don't want to, that's okay too. Just remember, the movement is generated from the body, not from the shoulder muscles. And relax, let them swing and hang. Other direction, from the back, up and around. And if you feel like speeding it up, go ahead. If not, that's okay too. And relax. Okay, number 9, home stretch. Hit the tiger. Remember to keep that weight on the standing leg, so that you have a free leg to shift into. So remember we talked about last class, don't fall into this leg. That's not quite the right approach. So think about that as we move into the posture. Stay on this leg so that you can place this leg, then shift and down. push off. Again. Push off. Again. Push off. Last one. And push off. Other side. I don't have my headband today, so my sleeves. All right. And step, shift. There you go. Push off. Step out. And back. And out. Back. Last one. And back. Excellent. Last one. Owl turns head, which we'll be talking about in detail in just a couple of minutes. But remember, legs, bend them, hands on the hips, head suspended, shoulders down, rotate slowly to the left. And center. Right. Center. Left. Center. And right. Center. And release. Straighten the legs. Lower those hands. Circle the arms up. Don't rush. Inhale. Press the palms down. Slowly exhale. Excellent work. That is the end of basic training. We'll bow out. Go get a drink of water. Shake it out. And we'll come right back and we'll talk about owl turns head. We follow the five hearts: faith, respect, perseverance, patience, and humility. About each of you, basic training dismissed.